Hello, and welcome to the second video in our tutorial series on online reputation management. Now we are going to be talking about attack type number 2, which is photo manipulation. Manipulating photos as a way to defame or soil the reputation of competitors has been a tactic used by big business, government, and others for as long as the camera has been around. There are two major factors that make online photo manipulation so much more powerful and so much more detrimental than ever before. The first major factor is accessibility to manipulation software. For the longest time, only highly trained photographers had access to the high-tech photo manipulation tools required to fudge a photo and make it believable. Nowadays, however, Photoshop and its free alternative GIMP are readily accessible to the masses. Access to these tools is no longer regulated by a professional code. Any person with a computer and a tiny budget could start mass-producing photos that misrepresent or falsely accuse. The second major factor in modern photo manipulation as it relates to the internet is the viral nature of photos on the internet. Before social media, and before mass emailing, if a photo manipulator wanted to share his or her work with the world, they would have to submit their fudged photo to a popular magazine. With the exception of the National Enquirer and other rumor magazines, these publications often required the highest standards in journalism and would immediately dismiss any sort of falsification of information. Now, if you want to spread a falsified photo, it can be as easy as a couple clicks with your mouse and you will have shared that photo with millions. Let me provide you with an example. This photo originally circulated the internet in mass form, claiming to be a photograph taken at a shopping mall in the Middle East. The photograph claimed that a shark tank within the mall had busted open and that sharks were freely swimming. This photograph went viral in every sense of the word. It made the morning news, flooded Facebook news feeds, and already had YouTube spin-off videos being made in the first 24 hours. It turns out that this is a photograph taken of the Toronto mall flood at Union Station. There were no sharks present, and luckily, nobody's reputation was damaged. But creative photoshopping and a determined graphic designer created this photo and this web sensation. But imagine the impact this may have had if this photo was used to falsely accuse or slander your business or even you personally. We have examined only two types of attacks so far in our video tutorial series that happen regularly to businesses and individuals on a regular basis. Though these attacks may seem intimidating, we shouldn't get discouraged about taking our business or profile online. There is much to be gained by doing business online, we just need to learn how to defend ourselves against such attacks. In the next tutorial, I will teach you how to perform your very own online reputation management audit.